It's Kara Newhart, and today I'm showing you how to spray paint your light fixtures without removing them. I'm breaking down the process from my viral TikTok video to show you how I spray painted my light fixtures while leaving them installed. There's many reasons why you might not want to remove your light fixtures before you paint them. Maybe you're really intimidated by wiring and uninstalling and installing fixtures. Maybe they're super heavy and you don't have any help getting them up and down. And maybe the shape of your light fixture just makes spray painting difficult. It might be really hard to get it to sit upright and be able to spray paint it. Either way, I'm here to show you all the tricks. I'm gonna give you my pro tips from prep to priming to painting to getting that perfectly polished finish. It's a lot of P's. Quick disclaimer, if you're just here to leave comments about why you should remove light fixtures before you paint them, this video probably isn't for you. Go spray paint your light fixtures however you want. We're gonna leave ours installed. Let's go. Phase one is preparation. This is ridiculously important. If you're spray painting inside, you have to have proper ventilation. When I did this, I opened all my windows and I was in an area where I could, you know, open doors, open windows, have a fan going, get some ventilation. I would also recommend wearing a ventilator because spray paint's no joke. You don't wanna breathe in what you don't have to. So make sure you have ventilation. Second, you want to protect things from overspray. So when you spray paint, there's a lot of little particles of paint that go flying around, and when they get on things they're not supposed to, that's called overspray. So I was sure to cover my island in a big drop cloth or a piece of plastic, and then I actually used a bunch of leftover cardboard boxes and I taped them to my ceiling using painter's tape. There might be an easier way to do this. I know you could do like big poster board sheets, you could just do painter's tape. However you want to do it, you want to make sure you have a wide swath around the top of your light fixture that is taped off or covered in some way so that you don't get paint all over your ceiling. And the final prep step is cleaning. You want to make sure your surface is clean. I hate cleaning so much, but this is such an important step to get your paint to adhere properly. So ventilation, drop cloths, and coverage for overspray, and clean them. If your light fixtures have a ton of buildup of grease and dust, the cleaner that you can use that's really intense is called TSP, but it will cut through all of that and get your light fixture all the way stripped down so the paint's gonna adhere really well. Phase two is priming. I know this is also a no fun step because we don't get to put that gorgeous color on yet, but do not skip this. Especially if you're painting a light fixture that is metal, you have to prime first. Otherwise, your paint is just gonna scrape right off, you're gonna be unhappy with the results, and you might ruin your light fixture. So priming is essential, but it's important which primer you use. So the one that I love using is this one. It's just from Rust-Oleum. It's a clean metal primer, so it's made to prime metal, which is really important because metal isn't porous. It can't absorb paint, so you need something on the surface that's gonna kinda grab that paint and keep it on. So I love this one, 10 out of 10 recommend. I'll link it in the description. So when you're priming, it's super important to shake this one really well. It can get weird and splotchy if you don't shake it thoroughly. You want to work in light coats. Light coats and let them dry between is going to make sure you don't have any dripping or globs or uneven areas. So go slow, work in light coats, let them dry. I promise this is going to give you the perfect finish. Just like your makeup look, primer makes it so much better. Phase four, the fun part, painting them gold. So there is one and only one spray paint that is gold that I will use ever. I have tried so many kinds. Many of them are really yellow, they look super fake, or they're a little more on the brown, bronzy side, and I just don't like the sheen. It doesn't quite look like metal, like the kind of polished, not too polished gold that I'm going for. So this is my absolute favorite. I will link it down below as well. I will say that Rust-Oleum has a bunch of different types of gold, but it is only this specific one with a little mirror on it that I will ever use because I love the finish. It looks like real metal. It looks bright, but not too shiny, not too 80s brass vibes. It's a little bit satin and it's just perfect. Okay, with this again, you wanna work in those thin coats and you wanna let it dry in between. The biggest mistake I see people using with spray paint is getting really excited, laying on a thick coat, which usually is what happens when you're spraying too close. You wanna stay about 6 to 8 inches away. Be sure you're moving around the whole time. Keep your can moving. That's gonna give you a nice thin light coat, which is especially important for a metal finish because you want everything to look perfectly smooth like it's real metal. So spray your gold on. Mine took about 2 coats to get fully covered and then let that dry. Phase four is getting that polished finish. So this metallic paint is actually pretty durable, especially when you're using it on a surface that isn't gonna get a lot of hands-on use, like a light fixture. So you actually don't have to seal it at all. I did not seal it on my light fixtures, but if you want to do it, you want to take that extra step, which makes them ultra cleanable and touchable without getting any kind of fingerprints or staining on them, you can. I would recommend using a satin enamel, just like this one. If you use a gloss, it's going to look really fake and really like that 80s shiny, shiny brass. And if you use a matte, it's going to pull all the sheen off and it won't look like metal anymore. It'll just kind of look yellow. So use a satin. It's kind of a perfect medium to that beautiful gold finish. If you've been around here a while, you know that I'm obsessed with any kind of gold finish. We're painting everything gold around here. If that's not your vibe, totally okay. I would recommend doing a matte black for this. It's a really good look that's a little more moody and kind of grounded and kind of neutral. So if you don't like the gold, try matte black. And for that, I would use a flat black spray paint and I would cover with a matte poly to seal. I would link those in the description as well. So now it's time for the big reveal. You want to wait till it's dry and then take down all of the materials you used to prep, so all of that cardboard and tape and whatever else you have going on, and then you're left with some gorgeous gold light fixtures. I absolutely love the way these turned out. I love that a couple $6 cans of paint could fully transform these. I didn't have to buy new ones. I think they're beautiful and I'm so happy with them. If you need more details on this project, all of the links will be in the description below, as well as the link to the blog post that has more images for this project. If you like this video, pop that thumbs up and then hit that red subscribe button down below so you can stay in the loop with more fun and fresh projects just like this. Okay, so which video are we watching next? This one? Or do you want in on two inexpensive items that will change your spray paint game forever? Probably this one. I'll see you in the next video.